you'd probably be as surprised as we were. This car is fit for a king and even the Donald himself, and it's got more than just excess charm to back it up. We found the 2005 Maybach also moves like a running back in ballet slippers. Its swift grace emerges from a long line of Maybach predecessors, its name paying homage to Wilhelm Maybach. Maybach worked closely with Gottlieb Daimler, spending the latter years of the 19th century building the first internal combustion engine. He later designed the first Mercedes car in 1901. It wasn't until 1921, however, that his son Carl began selling custom-built ultra-luxury cars under the Maybach name. That venture lasted until 1941. Now, 60-some years later, the Maybach name has been resurrected. With the performance and poise of a true top-line ultra-luxury sedan, the Maybach comes in two styles, the smaller 57 and our super-sized 62. Set on over 17 inches more wheelbase than the 57, our 62 is made for serious contenders with a chauffeur in tow. Its sleek yet stealth body measures 242.5 inches long, making it the longest production series automobile in the world, and over a foot grander than the Rolls-Royce Phantom. And unlike the blunt-nosed Rolls, the Maybach makes an elegant and seamless transition from the chrome dress grille with double M hood ornament and also logoed by xenon headlights to a wing-inspired hood, long upward-sloped front fenders, swift four-door cabin, and down to a trailing edge rear. Classic curves and distinctive lighting contour its timeless frame, all sitting atop 8-inch wide wheels with the light alloys housing 275/50R19s all around. Hammering down, Maybach's new 5.5-liter twin-turbo Type 12 power plant is the only option. A vamped-up version of the V12 used in the Mercedes S600, nothing else could produce the smooth velocity your majesty would demand. Its turbocharged 12 output is 543 horsepower and 664 pound-feet of torque, and is complemented by its variable camshaft timing system that eats up any hint of turbo lag and produces power everywhere. But with all this valor coursing through its veins, the 5-speed touch-shift automatic gearbox never misses a beat. On our humble track, the German supercar has enough power to haul its 6,340 pound body from 0 to 60 in a brief 5.5 seconds and clawed its way up the quarter mile in 14 seconds flat at 103 miles per hour. This V12 20-foot long sedan literally springs from the starting line and never pauses. But with all this vigor also comes some pretty amazing grace. This chassis is Mercedes tight and solid with no stretched limo-like wiggle. Its sophisticated control systems include electronic stability control, airmatic suspension with adaptive damping, and selectable ride height. Add in the speed-sensitive ball-type steering, and the end result is impressively agile and very forgiving handling. Even when pushed hard, this combination of big mass and unrestrained power exhibits only mild understeer, with a fair amount of roll, but no drama. Huge discs with electro-hydraulic ABS and brake assist-equipped twin four-piston front calipers bring the massive speed to a halt in a short 122 feet. Stops were smooth and straight. This is one ultra-luxury car where the chauffeur will have all the fun. So what is it like to ride in the Maybach? Well, this is one car that everyone wanted to be a backseat driver in at least once. Think of every cliche and analogy known to man, and you still won't believe it until you try it. Inside the Maybach, you truly have arrived. Virtually all of the 62's extra wheelbase went into the rear cabin for a true executive experience. The cabin itself transcends automotive comparisons. Think Ritz-Carlton meets Private 747. Leather, handcrafted wood veneer, and precise lighting sees all of the 144.9 cubic feet of four-passenger space. All appointments run from the driver's control room to the rear cabin with linear motion. Switches, buttons, and toggles command everything from the 21-speaker Bose surround sound audio system to the dual rear video screens, the fully reclining and massaging rear seats, to the electro-transparent panoramic glass roof, which can be changed from clear to frosted to completely opaque depending on your mood and sunscreen rating. In short, to say this car has everything would be a complete understatement. You couldn't dream this stuff up. A standard refrigerator, folding tables, champagne bottle, and flute holders, plus an optional Office on Wheels business package that leaves only one question. Where's the loo? Well, they're still working on that. Safety was also addressed in detail. An adaptive restraint system includes 10 airbags with front, side, and curtain protection. And designed to fit a little more than the manicured toolkit, complete with white gloves, the power-operated deck lid opens to 14.9 cubic feet of trunk space, about the only thing smallish about the Maybach. So, have you had enough? Want more? Okay, all those with deca-millionaire status, step forward. Yeah, we were left in the back, too. Just shy of the $10 million liquid cash target buyer class, we checked our hopes to commission our own Maybach at the door. The base price of the short wheelbase 57 is $325,000. But for just 50 G's more, you can recline in the base 62. But from there, the sky is the limit, since no two Maybachs are exactly alike. Indeed, for most of us, this car is a pipe dream. But for the anticipated 400 or so buyers of this magnificent 2005 Maybach, it's Trump change.